So I wonder whether that works actually now in Puerto Rico's favour.
So you can put your players where you want. That's the mind games we talk about. You've got to try and work out what your opposing team is going to do.
One, hold.
So, of course, something to consider is the player order as well, isn't it, Fraser?
Exactly. So the world ranking does matter, but then you might choose to drop a higher ranked player to let
to someone go be up as your second or third ranked player.
Exactly. Just to clarify there, because of course the world ranking does matter. It's the AVB and all this stuff.
City one.
It's a good start here from Piccoli.
Yes. 3-2.
I'm seeing here a few Adriana Diaz elements inside of Burgos's game. Full swing forehand. The backhand is very, very similar to Adriana Diaz, the way that she contacts it, extends it after. Wonder if she's got the punch as well. I must admit, I've never commentated it before. Like you say, she's had only 15 matches. This is the biggest event of her life.
Right, and that's got to be playing in her mind somewhere.
Mmm, tasty.
Yeah, she'd be happy with that.
Chefed up a rocket salad there.
Got it.
Good minerals mentally. She's 5-4 up.
Yep, she's got in front for the first time. She played in that Youth Star contender in Tunis and lost that against Hanna Goda of Egypt. That's one of five matches she's played this year. Won a couple. Yeah, that was nice.
Authoritative.
She's now in front by two. Yeah, the pressure now has kind of moved on to Piccoli of Italy. Should be expected to do well here. Expected to give Italy the 2-1 lead. And that, whatever happens here, we are going to see Stefanova in action against Adriana Diaz. I think that would be really tasty.
Yeah. I mean, you put your money on Diaz, right? But Stefanova's experience.
Right. The way she played just now.
Looking to avenge her sister there, Adriana. That's why it's important that whoever is... Whichever team's number one plays first, if they win, they guarantee they'll play again. Worst case scenario, and get back involved in the fourth match of the tie against the other number one of the team.
Yeah. Well, this has been good for Burgos. That was far too much height on that one, easily put away by the Puerto Rican. You saw the momentum there, well in her favour.
Windscreen wiper. Look at that.
Don't see that often, do you?
Alexia Lebrun would have been proud of that one.
And four game points. Well, it's been the day of the underdog so far in this tie. that a little bit short of the serve. Well, that's a good win for Burgos. But it has been the pattern so far, really, has been the underdog has outperformed the high-ranked player.
Lob one.
Rodrigo Diaz, in the end, did beat Ugaya Monfardini, but Monfardini played really well. We saw Nicoleta Stefanova win extremely comfortably against Melanie Diaz. That might be one of the most comfortable wins we've seen here on table one.
Got it. 2-1.
Picolin's reaction there is as though to say, okay, I know I can be giving more, but this player here is better than what I maybe expected.
Right.
Barely any studyable material of Burgos online.
1-3.
She actually beat Burgos Daniele Rios at the WTT contender Lima. Maybe she's the reason that Rios isn't here. A player who represented Puerto Rico in Chengdu. Playing at the moment, the Puerto Rican, as though she's already the number two for her team.
Yeah, at the moment, the way she's playing, certainly looks it. Piccolin's record, in 2024, she's already played quite a bit. 1-3 and lost 3 this year. Most recent match, lost to Young Ahn of Korea. The WTT feeder, Manchester.
That's a flashback there she's had, Young Ahn.
Oh, really?
Former world champion in mixed doubles from 2015 at the Worlds. I remember when she played with Xu Xin.
Ah, yes.
2-6.
Piccolin, much better from her in the second. What are you liking so far about Piccolin?
I'm liking her backhand, her extension here, and how she's trying to move on the balls of her feet, but I feel as though she should be showing a little bit more initiative. Oh, she showed that some in the surprise factor serve. Brilliant serve, but look at that disappointment there. Burgos was fooled, but improvised well and got a bit of fortune. Of course, apologises for that. Piccolin deserved better. Another windscreen wiper.
5-7.
I thought she was going to do it again here after the net. That's another Adriana Diaz element that we're seeing coming into fruition. Timeout called. Another windscreen wiper. Unusual how she pushed back the long push. Big reaction there. Great shot off the net there from Piccolin. Bravo indeed.
Nine, 6.
That's just been good since the timeout there. from Piccoli. Rally we've had, and it's Burgos who comes out on top.
Immaculate. Painting the table and painting a very pretty picture. And for class here, Burgos.
How about that for a Diaz-type punch as well?
Yeah.
Six of the last eight, Burgos' way.
Chop block from Piccoli, brilliant. Great feeling there from the Italian.
Oh, you're getting some passion there from the Italians as she moves to game points here for Italy. Two of them.
10-8.
And they've taken it.
Right, back at you, says Piccoli. Here we go for game number three. I don't see a way, Shazad, that Italy win this 3-1 in any case. Piccoli wins this, I mean, Stefanova would be the one trying to seal the deal in four, but you just can't see her beating Diaz, really, can you?
No, it's a big ask, isn't it?
Yeah. One, two.
And then, well, look, I'll tell you what's interesting, though, because if, for example, Piccoli, we go with rankings here, right? Let's say Piccoli wins this. That's 2-1 to Italy. Then you've got Diaz, who should beat Stefanova, of course. That will be 2-2, right?
2-2.
We've got a really interesting one because it's Melanie Diaz, who we have said has not been playing well today. She takes on Gaia Monfadini, who played really well. And if we're going on just today's performances alone, you'd have to say Gaia Monfadini is a favourite there.
So you're basically saying if Piccoli wins this, Italy would then be favourites to take the title.
You'd have to say that, wouldn't you?
Yeah, I believe that would happen.
Listen, if you and I are discussing this, they've done the math already, right? What's going on? It's really important for Piccoli to take this. There's a lot riding in this match.
So much.
Because I agree with you. I mean, Adriana Diaz has to beat Stefanova. We put aside that bump in the road earlier against Monfadini. She'll have to come storming back here, right, against Stefanova. As experienced as she is, Diaz is the favourite there.
Yeah.
But Monfadini's got to be the favourite against Diaz.
For sure. For sure.
So this really puts everything up for grabs. It's a tight third game here. Got to say that these sort of discussions are always fun, aren't they? I know we're speculating a lot here, but when you this kind of format, you start to look down the line, and this is where the positioning of the players is so important.
Such a stylistic sport, adversarial game of table tennis. Colleen here. Taking command of this. The backhand has been a big difference maker. Forehand-wise, there's not much between them, but there, you can see she's got a bit more quality from that side, Piccoli. Burgos has a good push. with the backhand and a decent punch and switch. Good blocker, but the way she comes in, it's hard for her to rip the backhand over with a counter because she comes in with a very bit more of an open racket face and there's more forearm.
3-point cushion, very useful now for Pickering.
Serve.
Do you think she's sort of now figured out her opponent here, Pickering?
Definitely appears that way, right?
Because there was that novelty factor, wasn't there, in the first game?
Yeah. Sits up. But fresh air, is it? Not the best receive, but it'll do. As with this game.
5 game points here. Pickering to take a 2-1 lead.
10-6.
It's pretty muted on the Puerto Rican side now. Right off the edge, Pickering. We could see that happening.
She's in a groove here now. This moment in time, I'd say Italy the favourites to take this tie, but of course, we're speculating again. Let's focus on this match. Burgos is losing a lot of these backhand trades. She's more comfortable at pivoting, say, on a third ball than she is in the rally. Willingly sending it long, but Pickering picks it off.
Italy are 2-1 up. And I think it's fair to say, you know, you and I, Fraser, were sort of talking earlier about what the final scoreline would be in favour of Puerto Rico. Let's be honest, we thought Portugal would win this.
I mean,
two,
I didn't expect to see the score that we saw between Melanie and Stefanova.
Yeah,
that was
correct.
The tipping point, wasn't it?
Yeah, you're right. That is the crucial match in this so far.
I mean, and imagine if Adriana Diaz hadn't have had the skin of a team from the first, they would have been scuppered.
As you said, I mean, right now Italy could be looking at a clean sweep. It was that tight between Diaz and Monfadini.
They've got more depth than Puerto Rico.
It would appear so, yes. I think it's not what this proves, this format is. You cannot be reliant on one player alone. That's why it's a team effort. You're right. Real problems here for Puerto Rico. 3 up, Pickering.
This be a tipping point here. Burgos breathing down the Italian's neck. 4-5.
Lead. 4-5.
Brilliant rally. That angle there really giving an insight into how much spin is on the ball.
Problems now as Piccolin is near the finishing line. Burgos has to do something here.
Awesome.
That's nicely done, isn't it? Great power generated there from Burgos.
Awesome flick. Shot of some swagger there. The reaction of Monfardini and Vivarelli, even they couldn't help but, like, oh, that was
impressive. Yeah. She needs a bit more of that, doesn't she, Burgos?
Six,
only a seven. Point in it.
Look at that for a forehand finisher. Inside out, went against the momentum of Piccolin's body movement on this final one after the punch. Bit of fortune, but still worked for it.
All square here. Good comeback here from Burgos. Long serve. Didn't work for Piccolin, and Burgos is in front for the first time in this fourth game. Oh, wow. Six out of eight now in her favor.
Tries to really slice that serve. Good change, though, from Piccolin. Oh, yeah. That's kind of ironic here because Piccolini means little one, but this would be a huge win.
Very good, Fraser. It would be massive. You're absolutely right. It is huge indeed.
Game two.
And Georgia Piccolin has